I'm a sober dude. I got offered mushrooms recently. I turned them down because the realizations that I can have on mushrooms as a 29-year-old man are a lot different than the realizations I can have as a 19-year-old. Because when you're 19 and you're on mushrooms, you're like, oh my God, I'm just a microcosm in a gigantic universe. But when you're 20, when you're 29 and you're on mushrooms, you're like, oh my God, I don't have health care. What am I gonna do? Quit drinking, man. Quit drinking. And when you're sober, you end up having to talk to the drunkest person at the party because you're both completely socially unrelatable. And drunk people have two speeds in conversation. It's either boring or why the fuck are you telling me this? I don't know you. It's either I like cats. Do you like cats? I like cats. Or I fuck my cat. I don't know what. Oh God! I feasted on her fancy. I quit smoking weed too. I will say this about smoking weed: even when you have like a negative paranoid realization on weed, it helps you become a better person, you know? Like when you smoke weed and you're like, oh my God, I'm so selfish. I'm so selfish. I have to stop being so selfish. I'm so selfish. I'm so selfish. But your drunk realizations, which are, you know, I'm gonna stop taking shit from cops. I used to drink a lot of PBR. I don't know if you guys knew this, but in 1897, Pabst Blue Ribbon won a blue ribbon for best beer, and they're still using that as an advertising campaign. In 1897, there were like three beers in America. So I was like, coming in first, Pabst Blue Ribbon. Coming in second, a jug with three X's on it. Third, some vodka we found in a dead homeless person. I used to drink O'Doul's. If Coors Light has a silver bullet train, O'Doul's has a minivan that gets you to work on time. I thought of the perfect commercial for O'Doul's. What it is, there's like a bunch of hot chicks playing volleyball and then like a bunch of cool dudes playing guitar. And then I walk in and I pop open an O'Doul's and I take a sip and I'm like, yeah, it's fine, O'Doul's. It tastes a little weird, O'Doul's. What do you want? I ruin weddings, O'Doul's. Yeah, I'll drive everybody home, O'Doul's. I used to have a cocaine problem. I couldn't afford it. Boom! Fuck you! Come on! Come on! Oh, ruined my life! I knew I had a problem doing cocaine when I was naked in my parents' living room doing lines. Naked's the official uniform of cocaine, by the way. That's like Superman's cape. And they came home early, and the only thing that I could think to say was, don't come in, I'm masturbating. You know your wife's in a sad place if masturbation's the safe option with your parents. So I went to rehab. Let me tell you something, folks. You know you've fucked up in life if you've been taken thousands of miles away from your friends and your family and the city you love, and you're in an open field with a bunch of other recovering alcoholics and drug addicts, and out of nowhere, a therapist brings in a horse for you to pet. You've pretty much gotten as low as you can possibly go if you've got to learn how to re-pet shits. Because the horse doesn't want to be there either, you know? The horse is like, is glue still an option at this point? My favorite thing about rehab is that there are guys that were homophobic who were in rehab, which I don't think you're allowed to be. If you're in rehab, you can't be like, so there I was on the Jersey State Turnpike, high on angel dust, missed another one of my daughter's birthday, and wondering what I just ran over was a speed bump or a person. But two guys getting married, gross! In rehab, every Tuesday morning at 10 a.m., we got to do sober karaoke! Huh? Huh? I thought the whole point of getting sober was avoiding karaoke. Like, you shouldn't be forced to do the things that you did drunk when you're sober. Shouldn't be like, all right, guys, if you're doing that sober karaoke, we wind up some beds, we're gonna need you to piss in them. But don't get too comfortable, because you got a whole group of fat girls you're gonna need to fuck. So, I hope you're okay with that. A friend of mine had a Super Mario Brothers themed wedding 2 years ago. Yeah. And then a year after that, he had a regular themed divorce. So, don't get cute. I can't stand weddings. My least favorite part of a wedding is the daddy-daughter dance. I think it's just such forced sentimentality. When I have a wedding, I want to have like an uncle and friend from work dance. The friend from work gets farther and farther apart, and the uncle gets closer and closer and closer. You guys have been amazing. Thank you so much. I guess I'll leave you on this. My favorite drink when I was drinking was Evan Williams whiskey. I don't know if anyone has ever had Evan Williams before, but I sum it up like this. Imagine all the other hard liquors and cocktails having an early evening happy hour. A late afternoon soiree, if you would. Evan Williams would be the drink that shows up drunk and uninvited. It's like, Jim Beam, I'm so glad you could make it. Come in, come in. Oh, thank you, Jack Daniels. Yes, it's been so difficult with the kids and work and all. And dear God, is that Evan Williams? Oh, make way for the mayor of Fuck Town. Hey, sugar tits, how about tossing a pity fuck old Evan Williams way? I'm gonna make your butthole look like seal's cheeks. Evan Williams, you are making a scene. Oh, look at me. I'm Maker's Mark. I think I'm a big deal because I'm a sipping whiskey with a college education. Well, sip on my dick, you Ivy League Goodwill hunting motherfucker. Sip, sip, sippy cup on my University of Phoenix Online Freedom Ride. Free Sandusky. Guys, thank you so much. You've been amazing. Thank you for coming out. Y'all have a good night.
Great job. You killed it.
Thanks, man.
Take a walk with me. I'm not going to be able to pay you tonight.
You're a piece of shit.